Bauma is behind us, and we bid you a warm welcome to the third edition of our UpLoad video magazine for 2025. Today, we'll be traveling across Europe and seeing three cranes in action. We'll also be taking a closer look at the solid link quick coupler system on the new LTM 1400-6.1. So, let's get started. First off, we head to Portugal. Last year, a huge cold storage facility was built south of the capital, Lisbon. A new LTR 1100 telescopic crawler crane, owned by our customer Transgrua, carried out the precast concrete construction of the 33,000 square meter building.
Garcia e Garcia is a company with many years of experience in Portugal. Our company was founded a century ago. Here we are working on a project in the field of refrigerated logistics. The location is very well connected in terms of transport. We are located very close to the A33 motorway, near the center of Montijo, near Lisbon.
We are building a prefabricated hall. To do this, we use the crane to lift the pillars, walls and girders. In other words, everything that makes a hall. The lowest wall element weighs 17.5 tons, the others weigh around 14 tons. When lifting, the wall elements must be inserted between the steel pillars from above and placed downwards. The crane's radius depends on the weight of the wall element, but because it is so easy to maneuver, I can move forward a little, lift the element, move back a little, and put it in place.
Due to the season, it is currently raining a lot and the ground is very muddy. These conditions make it difficult to maneuver cranes, such as a telescopic mobile crane, without getting stuck. We are currently working with this new Liebherr crane. Transgrua approached us to carry out their first project with this telescopic crawler crane in Portugal. We assume that we will have between 300 and 600 movements here on the construction site when installing the pillars, slabs and girders. With an ordinary telescopic mobile crane, we would need around 20 minutes for each support operation. I think that this telescopic crawler crane will be about 20 to 30% more profitable than the cranes we usually work with.
At the opencast mine in Hambach, a relic from the Cretaceous period of crane development is in operation. This ancient model, the only one of its kind, is the LTL 1160. It really is unbeatable, having now racked up 26,000 operating hours for the chassis and 40,000 hours for the superstructure. The four-axle crane was developed almost 30 years ago as the largest model in the then Liebherr LTL series, and today is still the most powerful tire-mounted rough terrain crane in the world. The close cooperation between Rheinbraun, the opencast mine operator, Vasel, the crane operator, and Liebherr produced a crane that was able to handle the specific requirements and loads of open cast mining. The lifting capacity parameters in some cases reach those of a crane from the 250 ton class. With its full ballast and a total weight of 121 tons, it travels from the topmost layer to the very bottom and, despite the rough conditions, handles open cast mining incredibly well. In open cast mining, the working environment is generally dirty and wet, so it's no easy place to be. The LTL 1160 was first sold to Rheinbraun in 1997, and 7 years later, Vasel took over the used crane. The special crane's first general refurbishment was carried out in 2011, with the second coming in 2024, both of them at our service branch in Oberhausen. Both times, the crane was completely dismantled. Components such as motors, cylinders, and gears were refurbished and repaired. Electrical cables and hoses were replaced. And finally, the giant crane was given a brand new coat of paint. Now the crane can deliver its trusty service for many more years to come and demonstrate just how unbeatably robust, powerful, and reliable it is. Green meadows, clear water, and picturesque landscapes. So now we head to the far north, to the Scottish island of Jura, where an LTM 1230-5.1 is being used by Stoddart Crane Hire to install a boiler in a distillery. Slangeva!
An LTM 1230-5.1 travels through the legendary Scottish Highlands. Its route initially leads along small roads through breathtaking landscapes. After a two-hour journey, it reaches Loch Kishon, a stopover for the 230-ton crane at the harbour.
So the crane was completely stripped down, the fly jib, the hook block, and all the counterweight off the crane to take the crane down to a maximum of 60 ton for travelling on our road.
From here, it continues its journey on board the landing craft, Carly.
In 2022, Stoddart Crane Hire were approached by White & Mackay to plan and logistically get their boiler to site. Unfortunately, due to restraints with Calmac, with the ferry service, the axle loadings on the crane were too high. So we discussed planning with Ferguson Transport and Shipping to take the boiler and the crane in by sea from Kishorn on a landing craft.
The LTM 1230-5.1 will spend 2 days and nights on board the Carly, cruising through the islands of the Inner Hebrides. After 130 nautical miles, i.e. 250 kilometers, the Carly will reach the island of Jura, where it will return to land in the Bay of Small Isles via a temporary jetty that was built especially for the landing of the 230-ton vessel. There are now only a few kilometers to go to the site. There is only one road on Jura. However, it is not designed for heavy loads, such as those of the 230-ton cranes. To reduce the ground pressure, the track was therefore protected with metal plates.
The distance from our temporary slipway to the site was a total of 2 miles. This was the shortest route for taking the equipment in. There was the public terminal, which was a 10-mile trip, but unfortunately, due to the road conditions and the roads built on peat, we felt that this was not the way forward for the movement. The narrow roads can become difficult for us, but we pick our cranes wisely for these jobs, and thankfully to Liebherr's product with removable ballast and taking crane weights down excessively, it makes a big difference for us on the narrow roads.
As planned, the crane reaches its destination, the Jura Distillery in Craighouse, after 4 days. This deployment was planned and tested for feasibility for 2 years. A new boiler will be installed here tomorrow. It is part of the modernisation project of one of Scotland's oldest distilleries. 1 week after the LTM 1230-5.1 started in Muir of Ord, the headquarters of Stoddart Crane Hire, the time has finally come. The lifting begins. Crane and crew defy the pouring rain. After all, the schedule is tightly timed. The tides dictate the time for the crane's return journey on the landing ferry. When a maximum flood level is reached again in 4 hours, the operation must be completed. Everything goes according to plan.
The boiler's total weight was 40 ton in weight, which we reversed to the front of the crane and picked up at a 14 meter radius and positioned at a 14 meter radius onto the plinth.
After the work is done, there's even time for a drink at the bar of the Jura Hotel. But only with a diluted Coke for the final photo. Thanks, guys, and cheers. Or rather, in Gaelic, sláinte.
Thick steel ropes, heavy bolts, and large hydraulic lines. Working with mobile cranes means moving heavy loads at some point or another, so it's all the more practical when all of the other steps in the process are easy. Solid Link, for example, ensures this. Moritz Schick has been developing and building telescopic booms since 2021 and is here to tell us more about it. Hi, Moritz.
Hi, Martin.
Moritz, what's behind Solid Link?
Solid Link is a hydraulic quick coupler system taken from the world of Liebherr excavators. We used Solid Link for the first time on an LTM 1750-9.1 in Ehingen. Here we couple the counterweight frame to the turntable.
And you've now had so much positive feedback that Solid Link is also being used on the LTM 1400-6.1, right?
Exactly. When it came to developing the new TY guying on the LTM 1400-6.1, we focused primarily on ensuring an assembly process that was as simple as possible. So we decided to use Solid Link here too.
And how does assembly work?
The crane arrives at the construction site, parks, and then raises the TY guying onto the undercarriage as part of the self-assembly process. It then lufts between the two TY frames, completing the hydraulic coupling.
So it's super easy, ergonomical, and fast. How many components does Solid Link actually consist of?
Solid Link is made up of two parts, an upper part which is attached to the crane boom, and a bottom part that's mounted onto the TY guying.
And how does the connection mechanism start?
As already mentioned, we couple up while luffing down. Just before the couplings engage, the two halves of the coupling are aligned towards each other using centering pins.
Thanks for these fascinating insights, Moritz. Well, that's it for today. I'm already looking forward to our next edition. We'll be back again, of course, with exciting new developments from the world of mobile and crawler cranes made by Liebherr. See you then.